welcome or welcome back to my channel. Nice that you're here and watching me. Today we're just gonna do some first and second impressions, try some stuff I have in my collection, see if I still like it, try some different combinations of concealer, foundation, powder and everything. So yeah, I mixed up all my latest buys and made some nice combos out of it, and we're gonna play with all that makeup today. Gonna go for a nice full face of makeup, do my eyes and everything else. So yeah, I hope you enjoy. I hope you stay here till the end. And of course, if you're here, please subscribe to my channel, hit that like button, leave me a comment, and if you want to follow me on my all my other socials, everywhere is just Sylvia Mandro. So yeah, please follow me there. Yeah, if you can see, I have my skin is not that good at the moment. It's got some spots here, here, and here, exactly on the opposite sides, but oh well. It happens, it's stress, it's my skin at the moment, but yeah, we're just gonna play with some makeup and cover all of that up. So yeah, stay with me, enjoy yourselves, and I'm gonna enjoy me. I'm planning on having fun, and I hope you have fun with me. So yeah, let's just get into this. So here's Pin Back, we're just gonna play with makeup. I'm gonna start with my Essence primer. Smells good, it's okay. I don't know if it does anything extreme, but I like it. I've tried it a couple of times, but yeah, I wanted to use this again because it's nice, it's cheap, which is always good. But to be honest, I always use primer, but if it does so much amazing things to my makeup, I don't know. But it's always nice to have a nice sheet in between your makeup and your face, so always do something. My True Skin in the color 020 Warm Beige. Again, this is the second time I do this on my channel, but I have tried it in between and I quite like it. But to be really honest, I have normal skin and not that many foundation I really hate. If it's matte, I don't mind. This is hydrating foundation. I don't know if this is supposed to be medium to high coverage. I don't know if it's matte finish. Yeah, it's supposed to be matte finish. I quite like it. It does the job. It's okay. So, but like I said, I haven't found a foundation that I tried on my channel yet that I really, really hate. I have a foundation I have a foundation I only used once and I have for a while, which is the Revolution Matte Base in the tube. Like I said, I didn't like it the first time I tried that, so. But that's the only foundation I think that I never ever use. Otherwise, I just every time try something else, try different combinations from foundations to concealers. Quite like that. But of course, I'm always going in with my Uno sponge. Ooh, I can get it. Which I already wetted before. And I'm just gonna plump my foundation up. Like you see, really nice coverage. Color looks a little bit different because but I have a really red face and I don't like it, so I always buy my foundation neutral because I like that better on me. So I always use a neutral foundation, and I think this is quite it's okay. So if you don't like neutral, if you want to keep it red and pinky, then do that, but yeah, it's just not my thing. I like it to be neutral. I like the redness to be gone off my face. But always so funny on the camera, it always looks so incredibly different color to my skin. And in real life, it's not that bad. And since I use this during the day, I always use just my skin color. And I think this one is actually quite good. Cover up those annoying spots. See, all spots gone. Oh, that's the best about makeup. Just disappearing all your sins. I love that. Yeah, quite like this foundation. Good coverage. I don't think it's really matte, to be honest. It's quite dewy in the end, I think. If you disagree, or it's different on your skin, of course, which is a possibility. Just put some extra foundation on the spots that I think need it. And I'm always using my BH Cosmetic number 8 brush for this. I don't know why, I just like this one for it. Let's press it there. Well, then everything got covered up nicely, and this is nearly invisible, because that's, like I said, the best thing about makeup, the fact that you can cover up everything. Something I love about it, and I think you always look so different when you wear with or without makeup, and I love that. Sometimes I don't, and I will go out without makeup on, which I have no problem with whatsoever, but I also go out with makeup. It's just what I feel like that day I'll do. But also very often that I do my makeup at night, at 8 o'clock in the evening, just to play with it, make pictures of it, put it on Insta, and have been not wearing makeup all day then. Yeah. My face in the frame would be nice. Get out of the way. Yeah, like you can see, nice coverage. Now I'm gonna try this foundation with my newest, my new Revolution Conceal and Defy Infinity. New to me, because it's quite there already. And I wanted to try if this works with this foundation. Last time I used this foundation with this actual concealer. Ooh, I like the color combo. Nice and highlighted. A little on the nose, right there and right there. Let's see how this combines. I like to do this. I like to try different products, different brands, different mixes of stuff together. So I figured let's do that on the channel so that I don't have to buy new stuff again. Because I already buy so much new makeup recently. It's still coming anyway, and I use the new bits that I've got. I will see. I'm gonna have fun. I'm just gonna play. Are you all gonna be here with me? I hope you enjoy, because I don't know, my videos are going quite weird at the moment. My videos, full face videos, go at the moment better than my eye videos, because I'm mostly try to do full face videos on Monday and just my eyes on Thursday, and last week I just managed to do my full face and my eye look, because I have vacation, but there happened something in my private situation, so let's bang this in. Wow, it's like that. Ooh, that's very light. It spreads a lot, so I could have used less. And going in with one of my newest powders. This is a Revolution powder, medium beige, and the loose setting powder. Which I still wonder if they're not supposed to be fluffy in here, but apparently not. Just going in with my Morphe and Jaclyn Hill G807 brush for under my eyes, which I always use. There are also some new brushes on the way. I brought a new complete from AliExpress, a new Jessa brush set with face and eye brushes, and I bought some Sigma eye brushes because I wanted to try those. Ooh, that's a lot of powder. Because I wanted to try some Sigma brushes, so I bought that. I bought the MAC Paint Pot, which I want to try as an eye base. Let's see if it works for me. And I bought a lip whip from Beauty Bakery, because I wanted to know if I heard something everywhere that is really hard to get off. So that's coming new in at the moment, which I quite like. Thank you. that on. Yeah. See, always this powder looks better now. Still shiny. I like it. Is this a setting powder? Is shimmery? No. Nope. Just normal setting powder. I think it looks good on my skin. You can see the spots there. I think you can see the spots there. And there. But yeah, well. Everyone has them, people. Even all the models. I'm sure of it. Not that I met any models, but I'm sure of it that everyone has them. Now we're going to contour. I'm going to contour with my the Essential Palette from Sigma and Stephanie Lang, which I quite love. You can see it's a little bit dirty already. We're just going to use the color in the middle today, which is Honeycomb. I use this one as my bronzer normally. Not today, but because I want to have a different bronzer. So we're just going to go in with my Beauty Bay brush, just a fluffy straight brush. Where are you? Got recently as well, and just contour. I'm gonna go with my bronzer, and I'm gonna take my bronzer brush from Essence, and I'm gonna take the Revolution Pro Sculpting Bronzer, and this is in the color Cacao, which looks like this. Looks like this, and this is quite good and quite recent. So I wanted to use recent makeup today. You see. I still like it, it's still okay, it's still any good. And I'm always shocked how good stuff works on my skin tone, on my skin. I don't know. Dead on, then we're going to get with my newest blush, which is from Milani, which I got as a present. And it's a little one, and I can tell you one thing, it will last even now forever, even if this is small and it's shimmery. I love that in a blush. See how beautiful. It's the only thing I've got of Milani, I think. Just this blush. I want to get more, but I don't know. Should I? I don't know for sure if I want to have this, but beautiful. Look at that. And then going with my newest highlighter, which is the Catrice highlighter in Ultimate Platinum Glaze, which I bought recently, which is very annoying. Yes. Very annoying to get open. And again with my Essence highlighter brush. And just make it nice and glowy and perfect and oh good. I love putting highlighter on. Oh, that's just 20 minutes and my face is on. Why not? Let's go in with my setting spray. This is a face fix from XX Revolution. A rejuvenating fixing mist. Again, I don't see that much difference in my fixing sprays, to be really honest. Yeah, let's just go in with my Essence and try this one with my Jessup 142 brush. This palette is not my most recent palette because I want to use the Stila Magnificent Metal. Is that called? Liquid Eyeshadow Glitter and Glow in pink martini, with together with my unicorn lashes, which are new. I bought off Beauty Bay, which I'm gonna try, and I'm gonna go in with my Carnival XL Pro, and I think I'm gonna do green with a spotlight eye, and then the spotlight will be the pink Stila, green pink. I don't know. I wanted to try. So we're first gonna go in with the color Mood. Mood, right? Yeah. We're first gonna go in with the color Mood, which is this dark blue greeny shade. And I'm gonna go in with my M506 by Morphe. Because it just works the best, I think. Now let's go in with Mood. Yeah, like I said, this is not the newest palette I've got. But ooh, beautiful, dark. But I needed to try this palette more. At least that's what I told myself. So pigmented, look at that. 2 seconds and so on, nothing. I love this palette. Look at that blue, gorgeous green. Amazing. Let's put a little bit more intense. I'm gonna go in with my M507, which is this one. And I'm gonna go in with the Hype, which is this green. So I'm just gonna use this to blend out. I love this palette. It's good quality, works really well. I also have the newer one, the Love Tahiti, but just didn't have the right greens I wanted, and this one had. And I always want to try, and I don't say I will always do this, but I want to try to use one palette for a look, because I don't know, I just like it better. I have one, the Beauty Bay pastel palettes lying next to me, which I may be using, but depends on how this color blends, these colors blend together. If I need to go that much more lighter. Wow. Yeah, that's good. Going back in with my M506 and the color I used for the first time, so the color Mood, so just to intensify a little bit. Now I'm gonna go in with Ecstasy, which is this color right here, the nice bright. And I'm using my Jessup 231 for that. Why I love this palette. Look at the vibrance of the colors that just work perfectly together. I love it. I just hope you're all staying with me. Let me know. Please subscribe to my channel if you're watching this and you came this far into the eye look. And Teresa, I hope you're proud of me. I'll tag her channel down below. I'm using green, which is her favorite color of all time. And I'm loving it. I'm gonna combine her favorite color with mine, because I'm gonna put pink in the middle and hoping it works. But we'll see. I think this works pretty good. Look at that. I'm gonna cut my spotlight. Where did I put my spotlight brush? Oh, my brush. I always use the same brush for cutting my crease, which is the P. Louise from Mirror Collection brush. This is the smallest, the one with the pink handle. And we're gonna go in, of course, with my P. Louise base in 01. Oh, if you hear something bouncing, the weather is turning around again. It was so nice and sunny when I started the film, and now it's raining and windy and chainsaw around. I'll be right back. I'm gonna do my cut crease off camera. So that's my spotlight. Oh, and I think it's not completely the same, but oh well. Try one of those Beauty Bay crayons. The annoying thing is that this blue. It's very hard to see which color it is. This is purple. And this is the greeny one. Minted, yes, that's the one I wanted. I wanna try put this around. I don't know if it's gonna work, but I'm gonna put it on there anyways. And I don't wanna put the glitter on first, I don't know. Can I? Yes, I need a mirror. So let's be the big one from the palette. And let's see if we can. This does anything. Because I love trying new stuff. You see it? Does it work? I can see it, but I feel like it's the same color as the... Oh no, you can. Yeah, it's pretty. But it's going on quite nicely. It was hard to see because of the colors of my eyeshadow. My P. Louise base turned a little bit bluish. Greenish, but you can see it. It's not as green as I thought it would be. But it's okay. Yeah, I like it. Now I'm gonna try to paint in the rest with my Stila Pink Martini glitters. Let's just see, just put them on directly. See if we can get this. See them as good as I wanted to, but we'll try make this better with my small brush. That's better. Works better with a brush. Ooh, do we like or do we like? Go back in with the colors I did before, just to intensify a little bit more. So different than what I do normally, but that's all that I like. I've never tried this shape or this way before, but I know. What do you think? Can I pull this off? I love the glitter. Stila glitter is beautiful. Well, we're just gonna do it under eyes. I'm going back in with Minted and put that on my lower lash line, on my waterline. liners come off quite okay. This one at least. I do have my liner dirty now because of the eyeshadow and everything. But I don't know, guys, what do you think of the eye shape? It's a little different. And if you don't like it, I'm just gonna go a little Halloween look. No, I'm just kidding. I don't know. I'm gonna go in with my bottom lash line. Let's just do it. Poke in with my pencil brush from 230 from Jessup. And we're gonna go in with the same dark colors. I'm gonna start again with Mood under my lower lash line. Going back in with the Hype to blend it out. And then again in with the light green called Ecstasy. That's that. Then we're going in with my Morphe & Jeffree Star GS13. And we're going in with the color Pink Me, this one. We're gonna use that as an inner corner highlight because that's with a pinky shift to it. Which I think should be appropriate, but we'll see. That blends in nicely. Doesn't go that shimmery. A little bit here. That's the eyes on. No fallout. There's no fallout at all, which I think is awesome. At least on my face, this is a little fallout in a pen, but I don't care. And we're gonna go in with these, so when I come back, these are gonna be on. Well, one lash is on, but oh, is that beautiful. Look at that. Beautiful unicorn lashes. You shock me. So, that's my lashes on, and these are the gorgeous unicorn lashes. This is a style Bubble Pop. Yeah, Bubble Pop, it's the famous. They're beautiful. Went on really easy, really nice bands. Yeah, love it. Works like a charm. Now, what issue I have is which lipstick goes with it. Should I go nude or red? Or would this work? Because this is my newest lip gloss. Try that. Why not try that? Going in with my red lip liner, which I'm gonna sharpen. This is from Seraphine Botanicals Quincy and Crimson Long Lasting Velvet Lip Crayon. Yeah, I think red's gonna work with this eye look. At least red and greens are beautiful together. And let's go in with the liquid lipstick from Catrice. This is the color 090. This is my statement. I love red lipstick. This annoying thing is applying it for some reason. Wait till it's dry. In the meantime, we're gonna do my eyebrows. Yeah, I think my newest eyebrow pencil is my Revolution pencil, and this is in the color medium brown. Going through them first. Yeah, I think I have to combine Essence with Catrice. So first Essence, because this is a color one. With fibers, if I'm correct. Otherwise, it will just be... a little more intense, which I don't mind, to be really honest. I like my fluffy brows, so I don't mind if I make them more intense. Now we're gonna go in with this gloss on top of it, which is a liquid lip balm, Powerful 5. And this is in the color 060 Dragon Fruit. Doesn't transfer onto my lip gloss. Yeah. Like in that one. And to shape them into place. Not that I'm going anywhere, but that's it, people. That's my face all done. I actually love it, even though it's a completely different shape than I normally do with the liner on the spotlight eye, but actually quite like it. Nice, different, not seen. Could be that lots of people done this, but I haven't seen it. Yeah, I think I'm okay. I'm gonna do my hair. I'll be right back with the last couple of bitties telling you what I think. So, lovely people, that's me done. I really love all the makeup coming together. I still have lipstick on my teeth every single time, but well, highlight, everything works so well together. Even though I use so many different, I think so. I don't know if you can see, but no creases. My lipstick is bleeding a little bit into my fine lines of my lip, but that's what red does to me. Look at that highlight, just Catrice, I mean, wow. I hope you loved it with me. I hope you enjoyed yourselves. I hope you had just as much fun playing with makeup as I did. It's a little extreme, let's be real, but then again, that's what I love. I do occasionally my soft looks, but I love this, it looks so good. I love those lashes. I love that stila, incredible, glittery. Hope it comes off just as incredible and glittery on camera as I see it in my mirror. Just my lipsticks. It's annoying me. But oh well. I love it. Please, if you come this far, also subscribe to my channel. Like my video. Put a comment down below. I have loved filming again. I had a blast. And I hope you enjoy yourselves with me. And follow me. Subscribe, please subscribe. And if you want to, all my socials are the same always, Sylvia Mandro. So if you want to find me anywhere else, please go. And yeah, see you on the next one. I loved you all.